So my friends, yesterday we talked about using arrays to show the commutative property. The commutative property just means that in a multiplication sentence, for example, 3 times 6 equals 18, you can just commute or move around your factors. So, 3 times 6 equals 18 is going to be the same as 6 times 3 equals 18. The commutative property means that it doesn't matter how I commute or move around my factors, my product is going to stay the same. Yesterday you showed this using arrays. Today you're going to show this using skip counting. Take a look. 3 times 6. So I know my first number is my number of groups. Then I know I have 6 in my each group. So, if I go down to skip counting, I know that my group number, I'm going to have 3 groups, and I'm going to have 6 groups in each. So I need 3 groups and 6 groups in, and 6 in each. 1, 2, 3. 3 groups, 1, 2, 3, and then 6 in each. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That lands me on 18. So I know that 3 times 6 equals 18. Let's go over here. My multiplication sentence shows me that I'm going to have 6 groups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And each group is going to have 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Going down to how I can show this using skip counting, I know that I'm going to have 6 groups, but in each group, there's only going to be 3. So let's see, I know that my group size is 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again, I land on 18, which means my product is 18. My two skip counting strategies look a little bit different. Here my groups are a lot bigger and there's fewer groups. And here my groups are a lot smaller and there's more groups. But it doesn't matter how my factors commute or switch around. My product is the same. My product is 18.